Good morning, students. Welcome to Gyanadiksha Concept Based Digital Learning. I am Ruchita, Subject Associate in Chemistry from Telangana Social Welfare Residential Junior College Girls, Chitpur. Today we are going to discuss about Werner's theory coordination chemistry. Before going to Werner's theory, let me explain about these coordination compounds. So generally, normal salts like ionic compounds, for example, NaCl. When NaCl is dissolved in water, it dissociates into Na plus and Cl minus ions. For example, you can take here double salts. So double salts, when it is dissolved in water, it dissociates into, for example, I am taking a double salt as a kernelite. Kernelite formula is a KCl, MgCl2, 6H2O. When this kernelite is dissolved in water, it dissociates into K plus, Cl minus and Mg plus 2 ions. There are another type of compounds. Let's see the formula, for example, K4FeCl6. When this compound is dissolved in water, it dissociates into K plus FeCl6 minus ion, but not K plus, Fe plus 2 and Cl minus ions. Why? That means there is no complete dissociation is taking place. There is only partial dissociation, like K plus and FeCl6 minus. Why? So that is because of the presence of a strong bond between the iron and cyanide. So because of this strong bond, that strong bond is a coordinate covalent bond. So because of the presence of the coordinate covalent bond between the metal atom and ligand, there is no complete dissociation taking place in this type of compounds. So such type of compounds comes under the coordination compounds. So let's see here definition. A fixed number of ligands which can be directly connected through a coordinate covalent bond. Just underline that word here. A fixed number of ligands which can be directly connected through a coordinate covalent bond called as coordination compounds. For example, just now we discussed that K4FeCl6. Let me explain some definitions in this coordination compounds first of all. So this here, the coordination number, the first one, it is a coordination number. What is this coordination number? So coordination number is nothing but here, the number of ligands which can be directly connected to the central metal atom through a coordinate covalent bond. Okay. That is nothing but here coordination number. When you see this example, here this coordinate K4FeCl6. When you see this example, there we have six cyanide ligands which are directly connected to the central metal atom. Central metal atom. Now the next one is here ligands. What is a ligand here? Ligand is nothing but here the capability which can be donate at least one lone pair of electron to the central metal atom. To the central metal atom. Now in this cyanide is a ligand and 6 is the coordination number because your 6 cyanide groups are directly connected to the central metal atom. Now let's see here another definition, that is coordination sphere. What is the coordination sphere? So the coordination sphere is nothing but the species which can be present within the square bracket, call it as coordination sphere. Okay, the species which can be present within the square bracket, call it as coordination sphere. And now let's see here. In this case, in this example, FeCl6 is a coordination sphere. And another definition, that is counter IR, or you can say ionic sphere. That means here the ions which are present outside the square bracket, called it as ionic sphere or counter ion. Ionic sphere or counter ion. And what about your central metal atom here? So central metal atom in this is iron. Okay, central metal atom is in this iron. Now next here, today we are talking is Werner's theory in coordination chemistry. Werner's theory in coordination chemistry. So Alfred Werner, he is one scientist who explained the structure of the coordination compounds and physical and chemical properties of the coordination compounds. And he won the Nobel Prize in the to proposing the octahedral structures of the transition metal complexes. He is also called as the father of coordination chemistry. Okay. Werner explained the properties of the coordination compounds by considering a series of cobalt 3 chloride with ammonia. So let's see here the first series, that is COCl3 6NH3. So what it is giving here, CONH3 taken 6, and here out of the square bracket we have Cl3. Let's see the second series. Now just I am explaining the first column once you observe it. The second series, that is COCl3 5NH3, and it is giving that CONH3 taken 5 Cl, and outside square bracket we have 2 chlorines, that is your Cl2. Let's see the third series, COCl3 4NH3. It is giving that CONH3 taken 4 Cl2 and here Cl. The last series, that is COCl3 3NH3. It is giving that CONH3 taken 3 Cl3. Yes, let me explain this second column of this table. What is this second column? So when you see the second column there it is the number of moles of AgCl precipitation, or you can say here number of Cl minus ions. So both are same only here. Now I am explaining the second column of this table. See here, number of moles of AgCl precipitation, or you can say here number of Cl minus ions. When you see the first series, what is that here? See here, one thing you need to remember here. This number of moles of AgCl precipitation, or you can say here number of Cl minus ions, that is completely based upon the number of Cl minus ions which are present outside of this square bracket. That thing you need to remember here. Okay, number of moles of AgCl precipitation, or you can say here number of Cl minus ions, that is completely depends upon the number of chloride ions which are present outside of the square bracket, but don't consider which are present in the inside of the square bracket. That is only AgCl precipitation is confirmed by only in the present of the Cl minus ions which are present outside of the square bracket. Now in the first series, we have only 3 chloride ions present. That means here 3 chlorines are present. That means 3 moles of AgCl precipitation you will observe from this coordination compound. Let's see the second series. How many chloride ions are there in the out of the square bracket? There we have 2 chlorines are present. That means 2 moles of AgCl precipitation we will observe there. Okay, now here, what about your third series? In the third series, only we have 1 chlorine. That means only 1 mole of AgCl precipitation we will observe. When you see the last series, there are no chlorine atoms are present in the outside of the square bracket. What it means here? That means there is no AgCl precipitation. So, no AgCl precipitation. Actually, Werner confirmed this formation of the AgCl precipitation. How he was confirmed that? Yes, by treating with the silver nitrate solution to this coordination compound. Whenever silver nitrate solution, by treating with this coordination compound, there is a formation of AgCl precipitation. Okay, that is, so based on that, he computed that the first series giving the 3 moles of AgCl precipitation and the second series 2, and the third is 1. The last one is there is no AgCl precipitation. Let me explain this third column of this table. What is the third column there? Yes, third column is your total number of ions. So what is this total number of ions? So Werner confirmed this formation of the total number of ions by considering the conductivity in the aqueous solution. Okay, by measuring the conductivity in aqueous solution. When you see the first series, just now we discussed which are present outside, that means 3 chlorines are present, that means 3 Cl minus ions, we just know we discussed 3 Cl minus ions, and one thing you remember, 1 ion is from compulsory coordination sphere, that means 3 plus 1 here, 4, that means from the first series, he observed that 4 ions are present, total number of ions are 4. How it is? Outside of the square bracket, we have 3 chlorines and ionic, that means here it is a coordination ion. One is coordination ion and 3 are chloride ions. 3 plus 1 total here, 4. Let's see the second series. There we have 2 chlorines are in the square bracket outside. That means 2 chloride ions and 1 coordination ion. That means 2 plus 1 total here, 3. Let's see the third series. 1 chlorine is present in the outside of the square bracket. That means 1 chloride ion and 1 coordination ion. 1 plus 1 here, 2. total number of ions for this series. Then what about your last one? There is no ions are present in the outside of the square bracket. There is no HCl precipitation. That means here total number of ions are also known. That means here zero. Okay. Let's see here next one. So by considering these experiments, according to Werner, metal ion shows the two types of valencies. Metal ion shows the two types of valencies. What is that? Metal ion shows the two types of valencies. One is primary valency and the second one is your secondary valency. Let me tell here what is primary valency, what is secondary valency. Now here, primary valency. Primary valency means it explains the oxidation state of the metal atom. What is that? Oxidation state of the metal atom. What about here secondary valency? Yes, secondary valency explains the coordination number of the metal atom, or you can say here coordination compound. Okay, coordination number of the metal atom. Let's see the second point. What is that? Yes, primary valency is denoted by dotted line and the secondary valency is denoted by solid line. Okay, primary valency is represented by dotted line and the secondary valency is represented by solid line. And the primary valency is satisfied by negative groups. Primary valency is satisfied by negative groups and the secondary valency is satisfied by both negative and as well as neutral species. Sometimes positive species also satisfies. Okay, and now here just now we discussed the bond between the primary valency species and the metal ion should be with the ionic bond. Okay, the bond between metal ion and the primary valency species should be with the ionic bond. What about in the secondary valency? Yes, the bond between metal atom and the secondary valency species is coordinate covalent bond. Already we know ionic bond is an ionizable bond and the coordinate covalent bond is a non-ionizable bond. Ionic bond is a non-directional bond and the coordinate covalent bond is a directional bond. Yes, now we are going to discuss all these like primary valence and secondary valence differences in the above series. Now let's see here the first structure, that is your CONH3 taken 6Cl3. So this is your structure. Now in this, what is the primary valency? Already we discussed what is meant by primary valency. Yes, primary valency means it explains the oxidation number. Now, what is the primary valency for this coordination compound? What is the primary valency here? Yes, see here, oxidation number. When you see the coordination compound here, ammonia is a neutral ligand. Chlorine shows the -1 oxidation state, already we know. Then, there we have 3 chloride ions, that means -3. Then, obviously, cobalt will get the +3 oxidation state. Now here, the primary valency for this coordination compound is 3. Let's see the secondary valency. What is the secondary valency? Yes, secondary valency means here it explains the coordination number. When you see the structure, already we discussed in the beginning of the class, what is that coordination number? This coordination number means the number of ligands which are directly connected to the metal atom. When you observe the structure, there are 6 ammonias are connected through the solid line. That means your coordinate covalent bond. That means secondary valency for this coordination compound is 6. Okay, yeah. Next see here, number of HCl minus ions, or you can say number of moles of HCl precipitation. How many number of moles there? Yes. When you observe the structure, 3 chloride ions are, 3 chlorine ions are connected through the dotted lines. So what it indicating here, through the dotted line means ionic bond. So what it indicating here, that means these 3 chlorines are present in the outside of the square bracket. That means these 3 are involving in the HCl precipitation. Yes. That means number of Cl minus ions, or you can say number of moles of HCl precipitation for this coordination compound is 3. Let's see the total number of ions for this. Already we discussed 3 are Cl minus ion and 1 is coordination sphere ion. That means total here 4 ions. Let's see the next structure here. What is the next structure here? The compound formula is here CONH3 taken 5Cl and the outside we have Cl2. Let's see the structure there. What is that structure? When you observe the structure, 5 ammonias are connected through throw the solid line, that means your coordinate covalent bond. Okay, and three chlorines are present around the metal atom, that is your cobalt. Around the cobalt, we have three chlorines are present. And when you observe the chlorines, two chlorines are connected through the ionic bond, that is, means here it is your dotted line. And one chlorine is connected through the dotted line and as well as solid line. What is indicating here? So it is nothing but here, this one chlorine is satisfies both the primary valency and as well as secondary valency. Yes, is that correct? Yes, that is incorrect. Because already we discussed, according to Werner, primary valency means dotted line, secondary valency means solid line. That means when you see, when you are observing this structure, one chlorine is satisfies the, both the primary valency and as well as secondary valency. Yes, secondary valency. Now, that means here, what is the primary valency? Already we discussed, primary valency means negative species. How many negative species are present in the structure? There we have three chlorines. Three chlorines are present. That means 3 is your oxidation number. 3 chlorines means here minus 3 is the oxidation state. Then for cobalt, it is a plus 3 oxidation state. Because ammonia is a neutral ligand now. So that's why cobalt will get the plus 3. That means the primary valency, or you can say oxidation number for this coordination compound is 3. Let's say the secondary valency. What about your secondary valency? Yes, secondary valency means, already we discussed, what is the secondary valency? Yes, which are connected only through the coordinate covalent bond. The ligands which are connected only through the coordinate covalent bond. That means here, in this, 5 ammonias are connected through the solid line and 1 chlorine is connected through the solid line and as well as dotted line. That means total it is 6. 5 are ammonias and 1 chlorine is satisfied both the ionic and as well as coordinate covalent bond. That means total 5 ammonias and 1 chlorine, total it is 6. That means secondary valency, or you can say a coordination number for this coordination compound is 6. What about your HCl precipitation? Yes, HCl precipitation means the chloride ions which are directly connected through the ionic bond to the central metal atom can only involving in the HCl precipitation. That means in this structure we have only 2 chlorines are connected through the ionic bond, that means your dotted lines. Only those who are involving in the HCl precipitation. Let's see here, total number of ions. What about your total number of ions? When you see the structure, 2 chlorines are connected through the ionic bond. That means 2 chlorines, just 2 chloride ions and 1 coordination sphere ion. That means total it is 3 total number of ions formed for this structure. Let's see the next structure, that is your third structure. What is the formula for the third structure? Yes, that is your CONH3 taken 4Cl2 and outside we have only 1 chlorine. Yes, that is your formula. Let's see the structure. When you are observing the structure there, yes, that is your next structure, that means your third structure. Yes, see here, there we have 2 chlorines are attached through the ionic bond and as well as coordinate covalent bond. What it means here? That means here these 2 chlorines are satisfies both the primary valency and as well as secondary valency. Yes, now you see here. When you are observing the structure, there we have 4 ammonias. Is that enough? Yes, 4 ammonias and 3 chlorines are present. Out of 3, 2 chlorines are satisfies both the primary valency and as well as secondary valency. What about here another chlorine? Yes, this is only connected through the ionic bond. Now let me explain this primary valency, secondary valency, and number of moles of HCl precipitation and total number of ions. Now let's see here primary valency. Already we discussed primary valency means oxidation number. Yes or no? Yes. Oxidation number. So already we discussed oxidation number means, sorry, primary valency means negative species satisfies. When you observe the structure, around the cobalt we have 3 chloride ions, that means cobalt will get the plus 3 oxidation state, that means primary valency for this structure is 3. What about your secondary valency? Secondary valency is 6. How it is? Yes, 4 ammonias are connected through the coordinate covalent bond and 2 chlorines are connected through the ionic bond and as well as coordinate covalent bond. That means 4 plus 2, because these 3 chlorines are connected through the coordinate covalent bond also. That means 4 plus 2, total it is 6. Secondary valency for, or you can say coordination number for this compound is 6. Whatever your age is your precipitation. Yes, when you see the structure there, only one ion is connected through the ionic bond. That means only one chlorine is involving in the AgCl precipitation. Means only one mole of AgCl precipitation we are observing. So, number of chloride ions or number of moles of AgCl precipitation formed for this structure is only one. Next, see here, total number of ions. What about your total number of ions? Yes, one chlorine ion and one coordination sphere ion. That means 1 plus 1 total it is 2. Total number of ions for this compound is 2. Let's see the final, that is your last structure. What is that formula here? CONH3 taken 3 Cl3. When you observe the structure, yes, when you observe the structure, 3 ammonias are present around the cobalt and 3 chlorines are present around the cobalt. What it means here? Yes, 3 ammonias are connected through the coordinate covalent bond and these 3 chlorine ions connected through the ionic bond and as well as coordinate covalent bond. What it means there? Yes, these 3 chlorines are satisfies both the primary valency and as well as secondary valency. Let me explain here. Yes, primary valency for this structure is here, which are satisfies only with the negative species. Around the cobalt, we have only 3 chlorines. That means primary valency, or you can say here, oxidation number for this coordination compound is 3. What about secondary valency? Or you can say here, coordination number. Yes, secondary valency for this coordination compound is 6. How it is 6? 3 ammonias and 3 chlorines. Because these 3 chlorines are connected through the coordinate covalent bond. Yes, now. Total secondary valency for this coordination compound is 6. What about here number of moles of AgCl precipitation? Yes, here AgCl precipitation, when you observe the structure, there is no chlorines are connected only through the ionic bond. Because here 3 chlorines are connected through the ionic bond and as well as coordinate covalent bond. Yes, that means there is no dissociation is taking place for this coordination compound. That means 0 moles of AgCl precipitation is forming. Total number of ions are also 0. Yes, from all these structures, cobalt, around we have some ligands, that is just 6 ligands. The bond between cobalt and Cl is the ionic bond and the bond between cobalt and ammonia is a coordinate covalent bond. So, according to Lewis acid-base theory, the one which is donating the electron, it acts as a Lewis base, and the one which is accepting the electron, that is acts as a Lewis acid. So when you observe the structure there, ammonia is donating the electron to the central metal atom, that is your cobalt. That means ammonia is donating, that means ammonia is acting as a Lewis base. What about here cobalt here? Yes, cobalt is the Lewis acid because cobalt is accepting the electrons from the ligand, or you can say in this structure ammonia. That means cobalt is acting as a Lewis acid. Yes. Next, see here. When I also explained the geometries of the coordinate covalent compounds. So based on coordination number, he explained the geometries. When the coordination compound contains the 6 as a coordination number, then it shows the octahedral geometry. So that is your structure. With the coordination number 4, it shows the two types of geometries. One is tetrahedral geometry and the second one is your square planar geometry. So these are the example for these 4 coordination number. And what about your next one here? See here next one. Yes, these are the drawbacks of the Bernas theory. There are some drawbacks are there for this Bernas theory. So what is that? Let's see here. The first drawback is here. He could not explain the directional properties of the bonds in the various coordination compounds. Okay. Let's see the second one here. He could not explain the color properties, magnetic properties and optical properties of the coordination compounds. Okay, that is the second drawback of the Bernas theory. Let's see the third one here. Why only certain elements are involving in the formation of the coordinate coordination compounds? So that is the third drawback of the Bernas theory. Yes, now I hope all you understood. In this session, we learn the, what is that? Yes, Werner's theory in the coordination compounds. So what is this Werner's theory? By taking, okay, cobalt 3 chloride with the ammonia. Okay, cobalt 3 chloride with the ammonia series. And what is the primary valency? What is the secondary valency? What are these characteristics? Now, let's see here we have few questions. Let me explain that. The first question is here. The coordination number of a central metal atom in a complex is determined by option A. I think I don't need these options. Let me explain by considering this question. The coordination number of a central metal atom in a complex is determined by, otherwise I will read distribution. The number of ligands around a metal atom, around a metal ion, okay, metal ion bonded by sigma bond. Bonded sigma bond. When there, what is that bond between the metal atom and ammonia, or you can say HCl? Ammonia is a coordinate covalent bond. Is there any pi bond you observed? Yes, there is no pi bond. There is only one bond. Already we know the single bond is compulsory, that is only sigma bond. There is no pi bond because after formation of the sigma bond, only pi bond formation taking place. Yes, that means here the first option is only correct one here. Let's see the second one. The primary valency of this coordination compound. The primary valency of the iron in the complex K4FeCl taken 6. What is the primary valency? Primary valency means here oxidation number. It tells the oxidation number. What about your oxidation number of this K4FeCl taken 6? We know that potassium shows the +1 oxidation state and cyanide shows the -1 oxidation state. There we have 4 potassiums, that means +4. Iron oxidation state we are going to calculate now, so that take it, consider it as a X. And -6, because here cyanide shows the -1 oxidation state and there we have 6 cyanides. So total it is 6. So when you do this calculation, you will get the oxidation state, or you can say primary valency for this coordination compound is 2. Let's see the third question. The secondary valency of chromium in CrEn taken twice Cl2 is. Already we discussed secondary valency. Secondary valency means here coordination number. Yes or no? Coordination number. When you see the En taken twice, what is that En? Yes, En is here ethylene diamine. Ethylene diamine. That means two carbons. Yes, En. What is En here? Yes, ethylene diamine. En is nothing but here ethylene diamine. Ethylene diamine, two carbons, two ammonias. Two ammonias means, yes, two nitrogens are ready to donating the electrons to the central metal atom. What is the central metal atom in this coordination compound? Yes, chromium is the central metal atom. These two nitrogens are donating the electrons to the central metal atom. How many ethylene diamines are there? Yes, there we have 3 ethylene diamines. When you observe there, one ethylene diamine contains the 2 nitrogen atoms. What about here 3 ethylene diamines? That means here 6 nitrogens are donating the electrons to the chromium. That means secondary valency for this coordination compound is 6. Let's see the fourth question here. What is the fourth question here? Yes, this is very, very important. Let's look at here. 1 mole of the complex compound CONH3 taken 5 Cl2 gives 3 moles of ions on dissolution in water. 1 mole of the complex reacts with 2 moles of AgNO3 solution to yield 2 moles of AgCl precipitation. The structure of the complex is, that is your question. When you observe there, 1 mole of the complex compound, that is your, this one is CONH3 taken by Cl3, gives 3 moles of ions. So already we discussed, in the total number of ions, 1 ion should be from coordination sphere. Out of total 1, out of 3, 1 ion should be coordination sphere, means what about remaining 2? Yes, remaining 2 are from chloride ion. That means while you are writing the formula, you can write 2 chlorines are outside and you can check it, the secondary valence should be within 6 in the square brackets. What is the structure here? Yes, CONH3 taken 5 ClCl2. That is the correct option there. Let's see the fifth question. A complex of CO plus 3 having molecular formula COCl3 XNH3. Okay, when dissolved in water, three ions are produced. Observing there, three ions are produced. Just you remember, three ions are produced. The number of Cl ions satisfies both the primary and secondary valencies. When you see here, it is giving the three ions. So out of three, one should be from the coordination sphere and remaining should be from out of the square bracket, chlorines. When you see, I think there before answer is also same. That is it. CO, NH3, taken 5, Cl, out of the square bracket, Cl2. What about your Cl2? That means out of the square bracket, how many chlorines are there? Cl2. That means two chlorines are present. That two chlorines are connected through the only with the ionic bond. Okay, see the structures before and then you can understand. Okay, that means only two chlorines are connected only with the ionic bond. Two chlorines are connected only with the ionic bond and remaining one chlorine is connected through the ionic bond and as well as coordinate covalent bond. That means one chlorine satisfies both the primary valency and as well as secondary valency. Okay, thank you.